Henry, who spent a long time in the U.S. military, is now back in Hong Kong. He returns to Tak Kai Secondary, which he previously attended, in an effort to begin his teaching career. The principal admits that he lacks teaching expertise. However, he is hired after being presented a letter of recommendation from a higher official. The principal tells Henry that the class he would be teaching is the worst in the entire school before he left. Henry arrives into his class on the morning of his first day of school to find it in complete disarray. Many of the kids are using a portable burner to prepare ramen while others are sleeping, singing, or playing video games. They continue doing what they are doing even after the teacher enters the room. They pretend not to hear Henry as he tries to grab their attention. After failing to get their attention, he stops trying and walks about the classroom making observations about what they are actually doing. Ramen has too much sodium, therefore the students who are cooking are advised to consume less of it. Then Henry approaches Zufa, who is playing the ukulele, and assists him. Similar to this, he cautions a young player about the radiation he might get from spending all day staring at a screen. He introduces himself and writes his name and phone number on the board when the students begin to pay attention. His writing is ugly, and the pupils laugh. He is then asked to leave the class by a fellow student over the phone, but Henry shrugs it off. Once more, the children turn a blind eye to him and carry on with whatever they were doing before he arrived. Henry decides that enough is enough and activates the fire sprinkler in the room using a rubber band and some chalk. In order to avoid getting wet, the kids rapidly dispersed. Once he has their complete attention, he formally welcomes them to his class. Five of the lowest scoring students congregate in the sports equipment room after class to smoke. The group's leader Jack has a crush on a grade student in a different class. He is made fun of by the others when they see him fixating on her photo. The group has a rivalry with the affluent and privileged basketball team players at the school. As they reach the supply area, they make fun of Jack's poverty. Later, Jack and the group watch the basketball team practice while standing close. The team captain falls to the ground as Jack spills a bottle on the playing surface. Ms. Liang, the English instructor at the school, orders detention despite the group's laughter. To avoid detention, they play a prank on her and run away when she is busy cleaning her desk. In another situation, the principal of the school is upset because the education board intends to take 20% of their yearly funding. The board members come to the school for a tour so they can see how the money is being used. While doing so, Henry walks inside the classroom where the pupils had prepared a bucket of water as a practical joke on him. However, he is able to shove the falling bucket aside because to his quick reflexes, the students who had been waiting to make fun of him are left shocked. Henry asks for Jack's packet of cigarettes, knowing that he smokes. Jack simply hands him the pack, curious as to what he is about to do. Henry then asks Zufa to list the three components of a cigarette. He is allowed to miss class that day if he provides the right response to the inquiry. Everyone starts banging on their desks, pleading for permission to miss class as well. He gives each of them a cigarette and instructs them to examine it once they stop. Henry is aware that people won't take him seriously if he just explains how it affects their health. Instead, he probes them about the effects of smoking and describes how tar accumulates in their lungs. They truly pay attention to the teacher and show an interest in learning for the first time. The students grudgingly accept when he asks them to return the cigarettes after the bell sounds. On that particular day in the cafeteria, the basketball team's captain trips Bruce, one of Jack's friends. This leads to a disagreement between the groups, which quickly develops into a brawl. They wreck the place by hurling food and tables at each other. Later, Henry learns that five of his classmates have been given temporary suspensions for inciting the altercation. Henry intervenes when he sees Jack battling someone in the corridor. When told to calm down, Jack complains that the school is unfair because the wealthy students are not disciplined. That day after school, Henry goes through the files of all five students to find out more about them. The first guy is named Zufa, the son of a Pakistani immigrant who is always discriminated against because of his race. He is frequently accused of stealing by the police officers in his area. The only thing Zufa ever wanted in life was to be a musician. A girl named Denon is the second student. Since the day she was born, she had been a disappointment to her father, who had always desired a son. Denon has spent her entire life attempting to earn her father's respect. She also shortened her hair to play the part of a guy while playing with cars. While treating her little brother like a prince, her father shows no care for her. Then there are the Bruce and Chris brothers. When they were young children, their mother left them with a man, which caused their father to become an alcoholic. Growing up, the brothers' primary source of support was one another. While Chris continued working in a grocery shop to earn money for the family, Bruce became addicted with video games to avoid reality. Finally, Henry is not able to find any information on Jack's family history. The next scene shows Jack performing his server job at a restaurant. Giant Ying shows up at the restaurant with his business partners as an MMA bettor. Jack tries to take Giant Ying's fancy lighter but is captured. He checks Jack's ID as Giant Ying's guys beat him up. He gives him some money and makes an offer to hire him as their food delivery man after knowing that he is a student. Henry goes to Zufa's house somewhere else and discovers him leaving after stealing a ticket from his father and his friends. He initially assists him, but after learning the reason why he is being pursued, he sides with the father. He then makes his way to the bridge with Zufa to hang around. Henry sings with a band playing in the streets to inspire Zufa to do whatever he wants. After being ridiculed at school for years, Zufa joins him shortly after and performs in front of people for the first time. Meanwhile, Chris and Bruce's father, who always arrives home late, asks them to bring him a drink from the shop. He yells at the brothers to leave his home when they continue to refuse. The following day, Henry visits with their father to convince him to check into a recovery facility for the benefit of his sons. Meanwhile, Denon's father brings her a bag of makeup products and asks her to act like a girl for once. Denon is furious at him for always making her feel like she is not good enough. With the car key, she sneaks out of the house after putting on makeup to her younger brother. He informs her that it is against the law to drive without a license and offers a solution. They then go to a go-kart racing track. Her father is also invited, and Henry forces them to compete. Throughout the race, the father and daughter are merciless to one another and eventually find themselves off the course. Denon manages to avoid being killed by a car when it suddenly collides with her go-kart. Her father, who is unaware of this, cries in sadness over his daughter's death. After realizing that he does love her, Denon gives him a hug. The following day at school, Bruce and Chris are taken with a group to a rehab facility to speak with an alcoholic in recovery. They are surprised to see that the person they have to interview is their father. The students ask him how he started to drink. The man answers that he loved his wife dearly, but she left him at the lowest point of his life. Hence, he started to drink and forgot that he had two kids to take care of. The man doesn't reveal that Bruce and Chris are his sons, but apologizes to them. By the end of it, the brothers are left crying. Somewhere else, Jack has started to work for the MMA better Gianni. He offers Jack a lot of money to poison fighters' drinks during the upcoming match. Jack is compelled to accept the offer despite his resistance. Gianni promotes a boxer on the day of the fight but wagers against him. He is beaten and confined to a locker before he can point the finger at Gianni. After a while, Henry shows in and asks the combatants if they have seen his student. The men ask Jack to go back home, but Jack yells for help from inside the locker. When Henry realizes he is being imprisoned, he attacks them and easily beats them. It becomes a little more dramatic when the boxers ratchet it up, but Henry deftly avoids their attacks. By the time it is over, he has eliminated their best fighter, who is scheduled to fight in a few minutes. In the following scene, they are at the hospital where Henry gets treated for his wounds. Jack tries to reveal the truth about Gianni, but is made to shut up. The news makes it to the television and Henry starts being known as the man who beat up a professional fighter to save his student. His popularity in school grows and the students start to respect him, in contrast to how they were previously. They even get up to welcome him to the class. Henry loved to play practical jokes on his classmates, as revealed in a flashback. In one instance, he even shot water balloons at a student who was playing the piano for the parents. Later, during a fight, he broke the student's hand. He was suspended for the fight, after which he had to fly to the States. From that moment on, the pupils pay attention when Henry teaches in class and put a lot of effort into studying for the upcoming college entrance exam. Everyone is doing well, with the exception of Bruce, who has developed a drug addiction. It comes out that Bruce started using drugs while Chris started playing video games to escape his family's problems. He performs horribly on the mock entrance exam as a result of his lack of concentration. Henry offers to assist Bruce, but as time passes, Bruce's depression grows. He eventually jumps from their home's balcony. He enters a coma after being taken to the hospital in a hurry. The news is twisted by the media, who attribute Bruce's actions on Henry and the school. Henry is examined by the school board representatives, who ultimately decide to remove his teaching certificate. The students pursue him as he leaves the building after packing up, begging with him to stay. Although they are devastated by his leaving, they are aware that they must succeed on their next test in order to make him proud. They put in twice the effort in their studies after that to convince the board that Henry is a competent teacher. On the test day, Henry texts Jack and all of his classmates asking them to gather in the school an hour prior to the exam. When the students gather, they find out that it was Gianning's trick to keep them confined in the school so they won't make it to the examination hall in time. He is doing this to teach Henry a lesson. Later, Henry shows up at school and knows about Gianning's plan. In order to prevent Gianning's followers from hurting the kids, he battles everyone while releasing the students. While Henry battles Gianning, they make their way to the exam room quickly. Gianning admits that he was the man that Henry had thrown water balloons at when he was younger as they fight in a one-on-one battle. It turns out that Henry was unable to participate in a top music competition because he broke his arm. He hasn't touched a piano since the incident and blames Henry of destroying his dream. He attacks Henry again despite his attempts to talk with him. They battle for control of a knife. Henry finally receives a pursuit to kill him but chooses not to. He apologizes for what he did when he was younger and then turns to leave. The students arrive at the testing location on time and finish the exam. Fast forward a few weeks, and they all succeed with flying colors. Giant Ying starts to play the piano again but has a lot to practice before he gets as good as he used to be. Bruce recovers quickly and promises to attend the next year's entrance test. The principal is also delighted because the board decides to give them a 20% bonus fund because their students did very well in the entrance test. Henry returns to teaching and does the fire sprinkle trick on another batch of students.